Welcome to a new Voltlog. For today I'm going to review this pocket meter, which was sent in for free by the company that makes it, and if you stick around till the end you will find out why I have two of them on my workbench. The pocket meter, as the name implies, is a pocket multimeter, and it started as a Kickstarter a few years back. It's designed in Sydney, Australia, made in China like everything else these days, and you can currently get it from their website pokitinnovations.com for close to $100. Now, you don't even have to test this device to know that it is not a professional multimeter and it will never replace a professional multimeter. You can clearly see that from the specs, which I'm gonna overlay on screen, but they don't even claim to be that, so everything is good. They have their own place on the market. This is a Bluetooth pocket multimeter, which means it doesn't have a display. It uses a smartphone or a tablet app to display the measured data, and it can do almost everything that a basic meter does. It can measure AC and DC voltage, but without true RMS capability. It can measure AC and DC current, resistance, continuity, diodes, and as a bonus, it can also do data logging, and it has an oscilloscope mode, but with a more limited range of values and functionality given its size. And I find this pretty cool because they managed to build so many functions inside such a small package. Like, I have not seen a pocket multimeter that can do data logging so far. And right from the start you realize why they call it a pocket meter. It's basically the size of a small puck. It's less than 5 centimeters in diameter and about 17 millimeters thick. And inside the box you get the meter itself, you get a pair of these custom made J clips. You also get a very small spare fuse, a small neoprene carry case, and a quick starting guide. And the first thing you need to do is to remove the battery cover, because there will be one of those insulating paper tabs that you need to pull out from the battery so the battery is connected and the pocket meter starts working. And from this point on, if you have the Pokit Meter app installed, it will automatically detect and connect to the meter. And let me tell you that this app is really, really nice. Like, I've used it and compared it to other similar apps that I've used in the past, a couple of years even, and this one is top-notch. Everything worked flawlessly. It just detects the meter very easily, it connects to it very easily, and you get the measurements. I've tried both the iOS and the Android app shown here, and they worked equally well on both, with one important difference, which I can't really explain, but here's what happens. On Android, you get one extra digit in the multimeter mode, and I haven't checked the other modes yet, but this caught my eye immediately on DC voltage, and I don't really understand why. It's the meter who does the measurement, right? The smartphone app is just a display, so why show a digit less on iOS? There must be some good explanation for this, but I do not have it yet. To extend the test leads, you just pull on them, and this is about as much length that you're going to be getting on these test leads. The cable they're using is flat, so it wraps nicely inside the meter. It seems of decent quality, but I believe this is a PVC coating. It's not marked in any way, so I wouldn't expect this to survive the soldering iron or any other type of abuse. It's just something that you need to be aware of. And to close it or wind it back inside, you have to press this release here, and it will wind itself back. And it's quite a nice little package that will help keep it nice and tidy. You also get these custom made J clips that connect with the main test leads. And you can connect them either way, like this, or you can reverse them like this, depending on your measurement point. You really have flexibility on these, and I think it's quite nice of them to include these in the package, because I often use J-clips in my measurements. In terms of specs, we can check those right from the app menu, and we can see we get up to 60 volts DC input, up to 40 volts AC voltage input, up to 2 amps AC and DC current, and all of these are with plus or minus 1% accuracy. and the resistance measurement up to 1 meg with plus or minus 5%. So these are not killer specs. Like I said, it will not replace your professional multimeter in any way, but that's not the point. I would see this as a backup meter, something that you can take with you when you travel. When you go to your local hacker space, you put your laptop inside the laptop bag, and you also throw in this pocket meter. And if you need to debug some small DC circuit and you don't have your full kit with you, I believe that's where this product can shine. That's why I won't be insisting too much on testing its performance, but rather see how it behaves in different test scenarios, how the app works, but I will still check basic accuracy on voltage, current, and ohms measurement. The app looks pretty clean. I like how the measurement is displayed, and you even get a bar graph on the bottom portion, and it just works really well. I can't stress this enough, because 99% of the time these types of apps just don't deliver the quality we expect from them, but this Pokit Meter app, it just does. I'm pleasantly surprised by it. And you can switch through the different measurement modes using this menu on the right side. You can see when you try to switch to current measurement, it asks you to confirm that, because you there's probably some internal MOSFETs that do the switching, and you wouldn't want to accidentally short the circuit your measurement by switching to DC current mode. So that's a nice feature, a nice safety feature, that they ask you to confirm switching to current mode. As I'm varying the voltage on this bench power supply that the Pokit Meter is measuring, I would say you get about 2 updates per second on this display. It's the same thing for the bar graph, and that's not a lot when you compare it with a professional multimeter, but once again, this is a pocket multimeter, so it's very likely that you're not going to care about the slow refresh rate when you're using it. That's probably going to be acceptable for the use cases where this is going to be used. Now let's do a basic accuracy check by comparing this with my HP 3441 6.5 digit multimeter. They don't say if the 1% accuracy is specified over the entire 60 volt range or for the specific ranges, but normally in the multimeter territory, that's 1% of the measurement range that you are in. And this meter has the following ranges: 300 millivolts, 2 volts, 6 volts, 12 volts, 30 volts, and 60 volts. And here are the results I got. It generally falls within 1%, but fails at its maximum input voltage of 60 volts when compared to my Agilent 3441A, which, to be honest, hasn't been calibrated in a long while, but it's a really good meter, something that you can trust. Next, trying resistance mode and once again comparing measurements with my HP 3441. The Pokit Meter does not have a zeroing function to null out the resistance of its test leads, but it is showing zero when I short the two test leads. So it could be that it's compensated internally in software because the test leads are fixed, so that's pretty much a constant that they can null out in software. Remember, resistance accuracy is 5% of the measured scale, which is not a great spec to start with. These are my results. As you can see, it meets the 5% spec on all of the measurements I checked, but generally the error is pretty big in this 5% interval. You can probably use this function just to check if the value of a resistance falls within 5%, but it's not actually good for an absolute measurement. So with everything considered, the fact that this is a pocket multimeter, sure, you can say that it's not great accuracy, but generally it does meet the spec, and for its purpose, it's likely that you will not expect higher accuracy from this pocket meter. Say, for example, you take this with you to measure some circuit on your car or check if a 5-volt regulator is actually outputting 5 volts, you're not gonna need more than 1% accuracy on the DC voltage measurement. Now, quickly checking the continuity tester, it's certainly not the fastest, but it's not the worst either. I've seen worse on full-size multimeters, and on this, the sound is nice. It obviously comes from the smartphone, and it's latched. I find this perfectly usable. As far as the temperature measurement function, it seems pretty useless to me. First of all, it needs calibration, so you need to input the actual temperature first, and this implies using a second measurement device. But then the sensor is internal to the Pokit Meter, so there are very few scenarios where this could be useful, like putting this maybe in some place like your car and let it do some temperature data logging, but other than that, I don't find it very useful. Now, to check the oscilloscope mode, and after playing with this function for a little while, I can tell you right from the start that this is far from replacing a traditional oscilloscope. Like, this could save you in a pinch if you really need to take a quick look at the signal, but it's not a real oscilloscope. I have connected it to the test signal output on my Rigel oscilloscope, and it does have some nice features, like you can select the voltage scale, the window scale, you can zoom in, and you can also add some cursors. Like, you can do a long press and you can add a couple of cursors in here, and you get some measurements. Like, we can see, for example, that this is a 1 kHz test signal. You have a couple of trigger modes that you can select. Right now I have it on auto, but the biggest limiting factor is the fact that this is not a continuous acquisition mode oscilloscope. It's just a single shot mode, so you have to click this button to refresh the captured data. Maybe this could save you in a pinch, but it's not what you'd want to use as an oscilloscope. On the good side, it does record the different capture points that you do, and you can recall these and see them on screen. You can also archive them and have them saved for later. Probably one of the most interesting and unexpected features is that it can do oscilloscope current mode. So you can switch it from this menu to current mode. It asks for a confirmation, so you can right now you can basically visualize the current on a time scale. So once I hit the capture button, I'm gonna vary the current limit on my power supply, so we should see a rising curve on screen after the capture is completed. In this case, because I have the test leads reversed, positive to negative, negative to positive, we see a descending curve. This could potentially help you diagnose some circuits based on the current profile, but given the 1% accuracy and limited dynamic range, just don't expect too much. Like, this will not be capable of measuring a current in sleep mode for an ESP32. As far as the data logging function goes, it can record the current or voltage or temperature with selectable fixed ranges as well as selectable intervals. So you need to select a range where you make sure that the measured signal is within that range. It will not automatically switch ranges. And the interval is just the interval at which it takes samples. And the nice thing about it is that you do not need to be connected with the smartphone. So once you start a logging session, you can basically close the app and all the logging happens on the meter. Then when you reconnect to the meter, it will retrieve the logged data. There are a bunch of things I didn't cover in this video, like the fact that there is a developer API. I also didn't mention that at first power up it identified the Pokit Meter needing a firmware update, and I clicked update and everything was done in a matter of 30 seconds. Once again, this app is really, really smooth. One thing that I tried doing and it doesn't support is connecting to multiple Pokit Meter. Just because I had two here, I tried connecting to the second one, but it can only stay connected to one Pokit Meter at a time. I'm also wondering how the device turns off. I'm guessing it checks for long periods of inactivity on the Bluetooth connection after that going to sleep. But how does it wake up? Does it use an accelerometer input to detect movement and then wake up? I don't know, but it's interesting nonetheless to think about this aspect, because given the CR2032 battery, I'm thinking it would be unwise to constantly wake up and check if there is a connection. Maybe that uses too much battery, I don't know. Overall, I think this is a pretty cool little Pokit Meter, one that I will happily keep at home. So it will not have a place on my workbench for daily usage, but at home, where random things need to be measured sometimes and absolute accuracy is not so important, I'll keep this in my home toolkit. And if you've followed along so far and you're interested in getting one for yourself, please use the links I've placed in the description to order your own Pokit Meter. They come in different colors and the company has also been nice enough to provide this second unit to be given away to a lucky winner. You have about 24 hours to enter this contest from the moment the video is published, and all you have to do is hit the like button on this video and leave a comment below to let me know how you would use this pocket meter if you would win it. The winner will be picked at random using one of those online tools that picks a random content. Just single entries are accepted, and I will announce the winner in a follow-up video. Then the winner will have 24 hours to send me an email to contact@voltlog.com with his contact and shipping info so I can ship the meter to him free of charge. Oh, and I will be shipping the meter from the EU, so you are responsible for any import charges, if any, are required by your country. As usual, thank you for watching this video, and if you'd like to support the channel, you can do so with as little as $1 per month via Patreon, and you'll also get early access to some of the stuff I'm working on, behind the scenes videos, and you can chat with me via Patreon. I will see you next time.